this class. In previous lecture, I have discussed so many questions, and in this lecture, you see few questions. Question number one. Question number one and two. In question number one and two, you convert it in simplest form. Question number three and four, find the value of x. And question number fifth, prove tan inverse root x is equal to 1 by 2 cos inverse 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x. So see question number one. Question number one. Tan inverse 3 a square x minus x cube upon a cube minus 3ax square. If we see 3a square x minus x cube upon a cube minus 3ax square, which trigonometrical ratio we take in place of x, so it get the exact trigonometrical identities. For this, in view of a cube, a square and here 3a, if you substitute a, x is equal to a tan theta, then we get a cube in numerator denominator column, and this term becomes in form of tan 3 theta. The, in view of converting bracket terms in tan 3 theta, we let us suppose x is equal to a tan theta implies that theta is equal to tan inverse x by a. Now tan inverse 3 a square x minus x cube upon a cube minus 3 a x square, tan inverse 3 a square into a tan theta minus a cube tan theta upon a cube minus 3a a square tan square theta. Here tan inverse 3a cube tan theta. If you take a cube common from numerator, it becomes 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by a cube 1 minus 3 tan square theta. A cube cancel out. It becomes tan inverse tan 3 theta. Tan inverse tan 3 theta is equal to 3 theta. From here, theta is equal to tan inverse x by a. So we may write 3 tan inverse x by a is the simplest form of tan inverse 3a square x minus x cube upon a cube minus 3x square. It's okay. And now see second question. Second question is, tan inverse 1 by 2 sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square plus cos inverse 1 minus y square upon 1 plus y square. Now, if we consider x is equal to tan alpha and y is equal to tan beta, for converting identities 2x upon 1 plus x square and 1 minus x square, 1 minus y square upon 1 plus y square in form of sine 2 theta and cos 2 theta. For this, tan inverse 1 by 2, it becomes sine inverse 2 tan alpha upon 1 plus tan square alpha plus cos inverse 1 minus tan square beta upon 1 plus tan square beta. Yes, okay, for few minutes. Stop few minutes, please. If x is equal to tan alpha, then alpha is equal to tan inverse x, and if y is equal to tan beta, then beta is equal to tan inverse y. Now tan inverse 1 by 2, 2 tan alpha upon 1 plus tan square alpha is sin 2 alpha. We can write sin inverse sin 2 alpha plus cos inverse 1 minus tan square beta upon 1 plus tan square beta, 1 plus tan square beta is equal to cos 2 beta. Now here tan inverse 1 by 2 sin inverse, that is 2 and plus 2 beta. If you take 2 common, it becomes tan inverse alpha plus beta. But tan inverse alpha plus beta, alpha is here, alpha is tan inverse x, alpha is tan inverse x, and plus beta is tan inverse y. It becomes tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. I think question is wrong. Here only tan 1 by 2, not inverse. Tan 1 by 2. So it becomes tan inverse x plus y upon minus xy. Tan inverse cancel out. We get here x plus y upon 1 minus xy is the simplest form of tan inverse tan 1 by 2 sin inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square plus cos inverse 1 minus y square upon 1 plus x square. It's okay. And question number 3. Question number 3. How can you prove tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2? Not proving. If tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus tan inverse x plus 1 upon x plus 2 is equal to pi by 4, then find the value of x. For this, see here, question number 3. Third question, tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus tan inverse x plus 1 upon x plus 2, which equal to pi by 4. Now tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So we can write here tan inverse x minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus x plus 1 upon x plus 2 divided by 1 minus x minus 1, x minus 2, x plus 1, and x plus 2. So finally, tan inverse, if you take LCM, it becomes x minus 1, x plus 2, plus x plus 1, and x minus 2, divided by x square minus 4 whole upon x square minus 4 minus x square plus 1 divided by x square minus 4. See here, x minus 1, x plus 1, that is x square minus 1. If you apply minus sign, it becomes x square plus 1. And if you take LCM here, the denominator is x power 4, x square minus 4. Then x square minus 4 minus x square plus 1 upon x square minus 4. X square minus 4, x square minus 4 cancel out. It becomes tan inverse x square plus x minus 2 and plus x square minus x minus 2 divided by x square cancel out, it becomes minus 3. xx cancel out, which equal to pi by 4. Here also pi by 4 and pi by 4. Tan inverse bracket 2x square minus 4 divided by minus 3 is equal to pi by 4. That is 2x square minus 4 upon minus 3 is equal to tan pi by 4, which is equal to 1. Tan pi by 4, that is 1. So 2x square minus 4 is equal to minus 3 implies that 2x square is equal to 1. Then x is equal to plus minus 1 by root 2. Hence, the value of x is plus minus 1 upon root 2. Now, you see, next question. Question number 4. Also solve for x. Tan inverse 2x plus tan inverse 3x is equal to pi by 4. Then same formula you also apply as the previous question. Tan inverse 2x plus 3x upon 1 minus 2x into 3x, which equal to pi by 4. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy, same as the previous question. So you may write here tan inverse 5x upon 1 minus 6x square, which equal to pi by 4. Then we can write here 5x minus 1 minus x square, that is tan pi by 4, and we know that tan pi by 4 is 1. So 5x upon 1 minus 6x square is 1. So we can write here 5x equal to 1 minus 6x square. If you transfer this term here, 6x square plus 5x minus 1 equal to 0. Factorize it. Minus 6 plus 5. That is 6x square plus 6x minus x minus 1 equal to 0. If you take 6x common, it becomes x plus 1 minus 1 common, x plus 1 equal to 0. So finally we get x plus 1 and 6x minus 1 equal to 0. Your answer is either x equal to minus 1 or x equal to 1 by 6. These are your answer. So which is the value of x? Either x equal to minus 1 or x equal to 1 by 6. Which value is satisfied in this question? If you put x equal to minus 1, if it becomes pi by 4, then correct answer x equal to minus 1, and for x equal to 1 by 6, if left side equal to right side, then we can say it's satisfied. In this way, we can solve question number 4. Now, see last question, question number 5. Tan inverse root x is equal to 1 by 2 cos inverse 1 minus x upon 1 plus x. That is, if we take question left side, tan inverse root x. So without taking 2 tan inverse, we can't convert the formula. 2 tan inverse x is exactly in 2 form, cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square, sin inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square, and tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square. In view of this, we write 1 by 2 into 2 tan inverse x. The 2 tan inverse x in form of cos, we know that 2 tan inverse x is equal to cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. So we can write here cos inverse 1 minus root x whole square upon 1 plus root x whole square. So 1 by 2 cos inverse 1 minus x upon 1 plus x, which is equal to right hand side, hence proved. Yes, in this way we can see so many questions, these 5 questions, and the remaining question I will discuss in next lecture. Thank you.